السلام عليكم برادر.
السلام ورحمه الله وبركاته.
The brother came and asked, he want to ask a question about who's, he is confused. Who's right, who's wrong. Can you elaborate on this one?
Yeah, no, I just would like to hear from your side of the story. I'd just like to hear your side of the story between the other brothers.
How are you
the
doing, Bodhi?
Not good, but just Shamsi, Muhammad Hijab, and Ali Dawa. Obviously, I just want to know your side of the story. What's the confusion? What's the beef? What's happened, basically?
Beef, or lamb, or goat, is not here. Beef, when you have problem for personal matters. We are Muslim. We, there's a book, I ask you to read it. Al-amru bil-ittiba' wal-nahyu an al-ittida'. Order to follow, not to innovate. The Prophet said, kullu amr, kullu amal, laysa alayhi amrana, fahuwa rad. Any action doesn't have my seal, my stamp, is rejected. This is twerking. Somali twerking. So كل عمل doesn't have our seal. This is to make it seal by Quran. What Allah said, ولا تقف ما ليس لك به علم إن السمع والبصر والفؤاد كل أولئك كان عنه مسؤولا. Shut up. This is from me, not from you. Shut up. And don't speak without knowledge. Because your ears and your eyes and your heart is responsible. Ali Dara, number one, son of a double muta, came from, why brother, why? If you come from a corrupted background, can you, brother, do you like football?
No.
What you like? Did you study? What you study?
Science, chemistry.
Oh my God, not yet. The man study chemistry. If someone from the sewage come and tell you, Sada, you don't know chemistry. What do you say?
Obviously, it doesn't make sense.
If someone come from, alaykum salam wa barakatuh.
Alaykum salam wa rahmatullah.
Sada, Alawi in Islam. The Shia say the Alawi kafir because they do incest as well. They do mut'a and incest.
You know the Shia?
The Shia do mut'a,
yes.
But the Alawi, they do incest and mut'a.
Both, two.
Yes. So, someone come from this background. And they tell you I'm jahil. He's ignorant. Why you bloody don't talk to us about your family? You know your family 20 years, 30 years.
Yeah.
What you talk to us about the jeans and the leather jacket you're wearing and this sexy thing. If you are ignorant, why you talk about Islam?
Yeah.
Ali Dara. And Ali Dara is a devil, son of a devil. Because he and Sheikh Donkey, Sheikh Tarawna, they attack.
I do apologize. Who's Sheikh Donkey?
Who's Sheikh Donkey?
This fat Jordanian guy. Attack in one time. They attack everybody. Abdul Hakim. This Jamaican guy. They send him to jail. Bilal. The Italian revert. They report him and they done a lot to him, security, and being attacked. Abu Talha, the Somali, anybody speak the truth here, they kick him out in a devilish way. And me, I've been attacked by six bastards. Somali. One Iraqi, Shia. One Egyptian, son of a Muta. One Algerian physically attacked, hit. But I'm standing here. Why? Because I'm not like you or like him. Because you might care about your family, you want to get married, you want to have a children. I married, I have a children, I had my money, I had my life. There's nothing for me to be, have excuse to Allah. So, this is not football, brother. If you, what's your name?
Sami.
If you go tomorrow to TV and tell them, I want to be like football communicator, they're gonna kick you. Who are you? If you go to medicine, you bloody work in delivery and you'll be like, why in Islam, brother, we have scumbags coming from nowhere becoming da'wah next day?
That's your issue there, that point there.
This is one issue. Another issue, I know one, not brother, one call himself Muslim, and he miss about with so many girls. And I know three women left Islam because of him. And one girl, 15 years old, he was gonna do job with her. She revert. Okay, if I give you da'wah and you become revert, why I have to sleep with you? Why?
Doesn't make sense. Doesn't add up.
No, if I am 17 or 18, maybe I tell you, brother, sister,
true,
can we do things together?
Yeah.
Is it allowed? I go to a parent, but I invite you to Islam and I invite you to bed next day. No, brother. If you go to the chats, how many do you miss about with girls, Muslim girls?
The chat. Oh, the
stream,
shit. Messenger, Facebook,
yes.
Instagram, TikTok, and
Sometimes people fall in love with a man, pretend to be a girl, and they end up with a man. Brother, you're gonna sleep with a man. Is it halal, brother?
How can that be halal?
This. What you said? Omar, is it Omar? Wait. Who? Muhammad Hijab? Where in Islam you show your boobs? A man show his boobs, both of them. Only in Hajj, you can show one. In Hajj, you can show one. But where in Islam, you come and instigate, I don't know. For girl, look girl, look, I'm going to the gym. You go to hell, man. What is this? And you talk about Rohingya and take your shirt off. You go to hell. What is it going to do with Rohingya if you take your shirt off? Brother, I challenge you. Wallahi, I give you $5,000. Allah my witness. If you give me one person making da'wah here, not for benefit. Either woman, either boys, either girls, either money, either selling anything. I challenge you, challenge me. Challenge me. Advertising, selling cat food.
Halal.
The bastard
halal
selling Quran app. The bastard saying, I teach you to salat in pound. Did Muhammad alayhi salam charge people for salat? Why you charge? Bring me people, I teach him salat and I give him 10 pound. Give me names, brother.
So let me ask you something about this. Just one question. So you're saying that these individuals that are coming here and giving da'wah, it would have been better off if they were more sort of learned the religion, more qualified, maybe from someone like a big sheikh, maybe in Saudi or whichever country that Medina, for example, and come and actually teach the proper way? Or you're more, not offended, you're a little bit more sort of upset that they're just talking from the little bits that they know. Is that what's triggering you off? What's triggering
the big conflict?
Yeah, the big conflict
with me and them.
What would make you feel comfortable and be like, you know what, these guys are doing the right thing and they've done it from the right way?
give me shred of evidence.
Okay.
Quran or Hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said, do this shit. John 3:16, John 3:17. Give me one in a trillion. No. Never happened. So this is invention. And the Prophet ﷺ said, كل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Every invention is misguidance and every misguidance in hellfire. So, is it invention or not invention? Because the Prophet ﷺ never said that.
Never said that. Don't pick from a verse from a Bible or an Injil.
Never.
Oh. You shouldn't even read the Bible.
You shouldn't read it.
It's haram to read it.
Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه وارضاه had a piece of paper, yes. 1450 years. Yes. Can you imagine? It looked like a four piece of paper and had Bible written. He said, yes. وَأَنَا بَيْنَ ظَهْرَانِيكُمْ You're doing this while I'm still among you. Wallah, I swear by Allah, if Jesus, peace upon him, come out now, you will have nothing to do but to follow me. Why you wasting time in Bible? Ahmad did that. He count 50,000 mistakes in the Bible. Why you go? We in Islam,
yes.
If a book have true and falsehood, yes. We throw it in the rubbish.
Oh.
We don't. If it makes it, we throw it.
Is it because the Bible's been sort of corrupted?
I'm not gonna go into this.
No, I don't wanna go into that. So you're saying that's obviously corrupted, and everybody knows it has. If they were speaking the Injil, which is the original one, you wouldn't have an issue with them comparing.
If they speak Injil, Injil, brother, inna ad-din 'inda Allah al-Islam. Religion to Allah is Islam.
Correct.
All prophets were Muslim.
Yes.
Some people call them Christian. What's Christian? There's no Christian. Jesus, peace be upon him,
Muslim
had a book.
Yes.
Musa alayhi salam, Muslim, had a book. Musa, he didn't say I'm Jew. Ibrahim, peace upon him, had a book. He didn't say I'm ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصراني. So, all the books are Islam. The real Torah is good at its time, but it's not good to me. Because it's been abrogated by the Injil, by the Isa alayhi salam book. And Isa alayhi salam book was right at his time, but not to me, and abrogated. Okay. So why go there?
Makes sense. Makes sense.
Give me a good question, man. Make me think. Give me taste me.
You're here to teach. So I'm listening to what you're saying. I don't want to argue.
Let me. I miss little bit of the answer. The best way to do in this time. Not to invent people. Anybody inventing new Muslim now is a donkey.
Why do you say it's a donkey?
Why? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Why is it donkey?
Listen. I tell you, wait, let me wait. تتداعى عليكم الأمم. This hadith صحيح. True hadith. The umam will come upon you and eat you.
Okay.
As the hungry people eating in one big plate.
Yes.
I don't know the word in English.
No, I understand it.
Yeah. And the Sahaba went crazy. Satatada'a. Yeah. In the future. Satatada'a. In the future.
Yeah.
And the Sahaba was little. And he said, how come? Is that gonna be little? He said, no. يومئذٍ are you gonna be late? Few? He said, no. That day you're gonna be many. But like a scum.
No, froth in the river.
Yeah. غثاءٌ كغثاء السيل. The scum of the torrent or something like that. So if you status now, scum of the torrent. Do you bring water to see how scum you are? Or clean your house? Is your house is dirty? Do you go to people tell them clean your house? Or clean your house first. Come on, Giza, please. Give me a break. It's better if you invite people to come to Islam now and you waste money and effort like these dogs, and the same time Muslim dying now.
Well, let me ask you, uncle.
470 million people now.
Let me ask.
Stopped.
Let me ask you a question. So how should we be doing the da'wah?
What is da'wah? What is da'wah? What this shit? Where this? Where da'wah came from?
How do we do da'wah then?
Teach you us. Don't do da'wah.
What? Don't get angry. What do you do da'wah?
You, Allah said, "Wa ma lakum." Why don't you strive for the poor and needy? You have to strive for the people who are dying first. Da'wah what?
So da'wah shit. How are we gonna spread Islam?
Huh?
How Islam?
You don't spread Islam now. You, if your house falling, you, if your house cracking, and you go and buy, build another house, you are a donkey. Your house gonna collapse. You have to fortify it or to make your house strong. But Muslim dying every corner. Somalia, these dogs, when they come and attack me, you say racist. 3/4 of Somalia now under starvation. Shall I spend my money to make da'wah or I save my own people?
It's a difficult one. Yeah.
I'm not going to count, because when I count, I forgot a country and hear you are racist.
No, no, yeah.
Palestine. You know what happened in Palestine now? Iraq, Syria, Rohingya, everywhere, man. You make da'wah? Give me another question before I go. Wait.
I'll go.
No, him, because we're going to finish it with him.
Uncle.
So do you think it is the end of Islam now? Because you've been oppressed now, you've been hungry. There's a question.
What's your advice now? How should we move on from it? Because you seem very experienced, and you've been through a lot in wars and stuff, and you've seen the country of Islam, you've been in it. What will be the steps in order for us as Muslims and our communities, whether from whichever part you are, how we can grow together? That's what you're saying. What's the next step?
In the Quran, strive for the poor and the vulnerable. You come here, you are from Eritrea. Yeah. How you came here? How come? You have money? Did you come swimming or you come by plane or this? These millions cannot come like you. You left them behind. What do you do about them? I'm here safe, I have mashallah, bloody very expensive watch, I don't know, may Allah bless you. And I have this, and I have this. Brother, what you done? What you done to your own people? What you done to your neighbor? You care about giving da'wah? And your neighbor dying? Come on, Giza. May Allah bless you. Let me finish this.